there, welcome to this video. We are going to see now the newest Microsoft PowerPoint 2016 and all you need to start using it quickly and easily. Leave us comments if you find mistakes in our language. PowerPoint is a software used to make slides and presentations, static or animated. This is one of the most powerful tools used in business and academic environment in order to show and explain a particular theme. If you want to see a simple example of presentation, simply download the PowerPoint file in video description. When you open the software, a startup window opens, showing you different templates you can start from. Click on Blank Presentation to open and create a presentation from scratch. A presentation or slideshow is a collection of different slides, animated or not, that teach, explain and show a particular theme the presentation is dedicated to. The workspace is very simple. On top you have all the tools you use to create and edit your presentation. On the left, the list of all slides made. At first, when opening a new presentation, you will have just one blank slide open on the rest of your workspace. Each slide is a page filled with different objects called elements. There are four different elements you can add: pictures, shapes and text boxes, tables and charts. Each element can be treated and managed independently from the others. You can add any element opening the Insert tab on top. Let's, for example, add a picture. To import one, just go to Pictures under Insert section and browse for your picture. To edit the picture, select it first. To move the picture, just click and drag. To scale, use the white nodes you see. In particular, use the ones in the corners to save the picture's aspect ratio. Use the arrow on top to rotate. To cut, copy, paste or remove the picture, just right-click on it. You can also add effects and corrections using the Format section on top or right-clicking on the picture and going to Format Picture. This opens a dialog box on the right. Use the Format section on top to use ready templates to apply brightness and contrast under corrections, color adjustments under color, artistic effects or the ready templates in picture styles. If you want to apply more personalized adjustments, use the Format Picture dialog box. This has four different sections. The first one applies fillings and borders. The second one applies different effects, like glow and shadow. Under Sides and Properties, you set sides and position. And, under Picture, you can adjust the picture itself, in terms of colors and brightness. Under this section, you can also crop the image, used to cut parts of the image you don't like. You can also add shapes to your slides. To add those, open the Home tab and choose the one you like under Drawing. To import them, just click and drag in your slide. To edit the shape, you can use the nodes seen for the picture before, by using the white nodes. The Format tab on top, or right-clicking on the shape and going to Format Shape. In this dialog box, you find again all the options seen before, from Fill Line to Sides and Properties. A particular shape is the text box element. This is a rectangular shape that has pieces of text inside. Create a text box clicking on the text box icon under Drawing and click and drag to define its shape. This is actually a text area that defines all the space reserved to the text that will remain inside. Then just type in. The text is completely linked to its shape box. If you ever move or scale, the text follows. You can manage any text box as seen with the shapes, using the Format tab or the Format shape on the right. What changes respect to the basic shapes is that you can set the text options. To edit text inside, just click inside the text box, when the pointer becomes a thin I letter. You can edit any text format, such as font, style, size and color, through the options inside Format on top or under text options in Format shape. Those changes are applied on all text fully by default, but you can select any part you like if you want to apply your modifications just on such parts of text only. There are two more complicated elements available in PowerPoint: tables and charts. You can insert tables going to Table under Insert section, deciding the number of rows and columns. You can move and scale tables as seen for the other elements, but you can't rotate. Fill each cell clicking inside. You can adjust each row and column size dragging their borders. Each cell can be seen and treated as text box. In fact, if you right-click on a cell, you can adjust its text and shape format as seen for text boxes. On top, under Design, adjust borders, filling and color. Under Layout, you can add and delete columns and rows if you need. Then you have the charts. First of all, to import a chart, you do need a database saved in Microsoft Excel. If you have one, use Chart under Insert section to create one. And then import your data, going to Design on top and to Edit Data in Excel. Through Excel, all data used in the chart is shown. Just copy and paste your own data and edit values and titles if you need. The chart will be automatically refreshed. In Design, you can also add other elements and titles, change the basic layout, pick the chart template you like most, or change the kind of chart going on Change Chart Type. You can change the aspect of the chart going to Format on top or the dialog box on the right. Those different elements together compose each slide of your presentation. However, it may happen that some of these may get overlapped each other. You can set which element must be in front or above others, selecting it and using the Arrange options in the Home tab. You can create a new slide going to New Slide on top, selecting its layout template through Layout. When more slides are made, all of these are listed on the left, and it is shown the selected slide under a red thick border contour. You can cut, copy, paste and delete selected slides right-clicking on them. You can also arrange the slides list by pulling them up or down. To see a preview of your presentation, just go to Slideshow on top. The presentation will follow exactly the same order of slides positioned. Click or use your arrow keys to shuffle between one and the other. Use Escape key to end the presentation. If you stop here, you will build a static presentation, passing from one slide to the other without effects. In PowerPoint, you can also add transitions and animations. Transitions are used to introduce the following slide with a nice effect. Select the slide to introduce from the list and open the Transitions tab. When you select one, you will see its preview on your workspace. If the duration is too short, change its seconds on duration. You can change the kind of the transition through effect options, and you can also add sound effects going to sound. Use Preview on the extreme left to check the latest settings applied. Select the None transition to remove any transition applied. While transitions are applied on slides, animations are used to add effects on elements inside the same slide. Any element inside a slide can be static, so visible and fixed, or have effects in order to appear, move, or disappear. To apply an animation on an element, just select it and go to the Animations tab to choose which animation to apply. You can choose between four kinds of animations. Entrance animations, in green, are used to make an element appear. Emphasis, in yellow, is used to highlight the element. Exit animations, in red, are used to make an element disappear. Motion paths are used to make an element move through its slide. This motion goes from the green arrow or point to the red one. The motion path can be edited as you do with a simple shape. If you ever need more animations, you can click on the downer arrow. To add more animations on the same element, just select from Add Animation. To check all the animations applied on an element, just go to Animation Pane on top. This shows you all the animations applied in their order. Colors suggest you how to apply these animations. The first one must be the green one, followed by the yellow and any motion path. Then you can end with the red one. If you don't respect this order, you may not see all the animations, since some may be ignored or hidden. You can select each animation clicking from the animation pane or from the numbers shown in the element. Then you can edit it, changing the kind of animation on top. Under timing, use Start to regulate when to start the animation, in the moment you click, or during or after the previous animation. Through duration and delay, set the duration and the delay of the animation. All times are in seconds. You can also set the animation duration, changing the width of the rectangle on the right, next to the interested animation. To check a preview, click on Play From. This starts from the selected animation onwards. PowerPoint always follows the animation order, in case you have one or more elements animated. This order is specified by numbers close to each animated element. You can edit this order by clicking and dragging each animation in the list on the right. When you apply transitions or animations on elements, the related slide will show a star symbol below its number. When you finish, simply save your project. Go to File and then to Save As. .pptx projects not only are made to open your work back to edit it if you need, but it is also the presentation itself, ready to be opened and shown through the slideshow section. You can also save it as a .pdf file in order to print all your slides or show them, but mind that this format loses any transition or animation. Thanks for watching. Check out our Microsoft Office 2016 guide for more.